Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I have this really soft natural glam look for you. I have something that you can wear every day with every outfit. So this is a really versatile look. I hope you guys like this look, so keep watching. But before I do that, don't forget to hit that like, subscribe and the bell button down there so that you get notified every time I post a video. Also, don't forget to follow me on my Instagram, Facebook and TikTok handle so that we can be friends. And I post a lot of funny stuff and tutorials also, like really mini short tutorials, something that you can watch when you're on the go. With that, let's jump right into the tutorial right now. So let's start with our face first. I will be using this primer by First Aid Beauty. This is a coconut smoothie primer. It does have a little bit of a shine, so kind of place off of the foundation. Ooh, everything is so cold because of the weather. Pretty cold outside. Because today's makeup is natural glam, something that you can wear even outside during daytime, I will be using this sheer to medium foundation. This is by Dior. It's Dior Backstage, one of my favorite foundations. So I'm just going to give it a little shake. Oh, just in case, this is how the case looks. I'm gonna take, and with this Huda Beauty buff and blend face foundation brush, I'm going to take the foundation and I'm going to buff and blend. Build coverage from any foundation, you have to first apply a little bit of powder. What this does, let me grab my brush first. So what this does is it seals the first layer and then you can go on with the second layer. I'm taking L'Oreal Mercier Loose Translucent Powder, or any translucent powder would work, and I'm going to just slightly dust it all over my face. If you don't do that, you really won't see any coverage. You will be just picking up the same foundation and putting it right back again. Now I'm going to quickly do my eyebrows off the camera and I'll be right back. And I'm back. Now I'm going to start with the eye makeup. For my eye makeup, I will be first concealing my eyes. They are not well concealed. So I'm using the Huda Beauty foundation, Huda Beauty concealer from Huda Beauty. Put a little bit here, put a little bit here, under my eyes. Do it then with a small heart or a beauty blender or a brush, anything, whichever works for you, as long as you are blending it. If you're doing it with your finger, just make sure that you are using your ring finger, like, because that puts the lightest pressures, the one you actually should be using to even apply your eye cream, your ring finger. I'm going to just make sure that this is well covered. You can even use any eyeshadow primer. Then again, I'm going to dust a little loose translucent powder. I'm using Laura Mercier loose translucent powder. You guys already know that that is my the bomb loose translucent powder. For today's eye makeup, I will be using this palette from KKW Beauty. This is the, I don't see the name, it's just KKW Beauty palette, but these are the colors in the palette. They are very neutral colors. Now with a soft blending brush like this one, this is Luxe 231. This is a small tapered blending brush. I'm going to take the color, which is like really pale. The color is called Florence. And I'm going to go in my crease. Today's makeup is about like really soft, barely there. Taper it outside. Now I'm going to take a little darker color, which is this one. This one is called Calabasas. I'm going to take the same blending brush and I'm going to go build over the previous color, make a richer crease. Now I'm going to take the the darkest color in the palette, which is a real dark brown, and this is called Gemini. And I'm going to focus it more on the outer corner of my eyes to just give me more depth of color and also the shape or the structure, build a structure. Yeah, I think that is a better term. I'm gonna flick it outside and I'm going to just blend it with all the two other previous colors that I had on. Now I'm going to take the reddish brown color right here, which is called Family, and I'm going to place it from the outer corner towards inside, like right about here, to give it a nice contrast. Now with a softer flat blending brush like this, Morphe M421. I'm going to take the lightest color, which is like beige, very pale beige, very similar to MAC Brulee. This is called Fade in this palette, and I'm going to take that color and I'm going to place it from my inner corner, almost carving out a crease. Like that. One of my biggest pet peeves is when I'm applying eyeshadow and I can see the dust of that eyeshadow flying. It is one of my biggest pet peeves. Not that this one ain't doing that. Now I'm going to take this shimmery pale gold color right here, and this one is called Saint. I'm going to take the same brush and I'm going to press, because this seems to be a creamier texture. Okay, more like a satin texture. And I'm going to just place it on top of the previous color, the lightest color, which I placed in the inner corner of my eye. I'm going to take another blending brush and I'm going to go in with that lightest color, which I used for the inner corner of my eye, and I'm going to place it right here on the eyebrow bone, just to brighten things up a little bit. And I'm using a very soft blending brush. This also creates the illusion of your eyebrow bone being higher, hence a better arched eyebrow. Now I'm going to go in under on my lower eyelid using Morphe M33. This brush is tapered long, but it is so soft and the best brush for your under eyes. I'm going to take this color, this caramel color, which I have already used for my upper eyes, and it's called Calabasas. I'm going to take a little bit, dip, and I'm going to go under my eyes just like that. Now I'm going to go in with the same brush, but with the darkest color in the palette, which is called Gemini, which I've already used on the outer corner of my upper eyelids. I'm going to just place it and focus it more on the outer corners to stitch everything up really well. You don't want to see the stitch, but you still want your clothes to not fall apart when you have them on, right? It's kind of like that. Once we are done with that, I'm going to go in with that matte color and I'm going to mix it with the shimmery color. And with that combination, I'm going to just put it on my inner corner right here to just, you know, brighten things up a little bit more. Let me jump onto my face first. I'm going to start by my contour and highlight routine. For my contouring today, I'm going to use this product that I'm in total love with. That is Elaluz, super yummy. And I'm going to carve out all the places that I want to contour, just like the top of my forehead, of course, the cheekbone, the jaw, the nose, and underneath my lips. Beautiful. And your makeup's done. No, we're just getting started. Contour and highlight brush. This is Kat Von D shade and light brush. It came in a coffin, which was totally cool. It came in a coffin case, a case that looked like a coffin. Blend all the contour. So I'm going to blend it out. A On top of it, I'm going to use NARS Laguna bronzer. This is a powder bronzer. So I'm just going to go on top of the cream bronzer to intensify it even more. For my highlight, I'm going to use the highlighter from KKW Beauty. This is Glitz Glam. It's a pale gold color highlighter. There you go. I'm going to take the other side of this shade and light brush, which is the highlighting side, and I'm going to just go on top of the high points of my face, like the cheekbones, tip of my nose, bridge of my nose. I also like to put a little bit on top of the arch of my eyebrows to kind of reflect, like stitching with the cheek, you know. For blush, I'm going to use KKW Beauty Luxe, which is a very pale color. It's very neutral pink color, and I'm going to just go from my apples of the cheek till my forehead to give me a facelift. Who needs a facelift when you've got blush? Just like that. Next, I will be using Laura Mercier Candle Glow Powder. This is a very nice powder with a light shine, almost like candle glow, just like the name. I will be using my fan brush. You can also use your powder brush, and I'm going to go lightly all over my face. This will give me an overall glow. Now I'm going to use Hourglass Diffuse Dim Light, which is this color, again to give me a little bit more subtle candlelight glow. So I'm just going to go in and just touch the top parts of my face, not too much, very lightly. For my lips, I will be using MAC Lip Pencil Spice to line my lips. I like to make the edges of my lip liner blunt, that way it goes on better, and smile. That way not only does it go smoother because your lips are taut, but also it fills up really well. For lipstick, I'm using MAC Liptensity. This is the color Doe. It's again a very nude, muted. Has a little peach in it. I'm going to now quickly go off the camera, put on the mascara, lashes, and I'll be right back. And I'm back. I'm now going to just spray some Fix Plus on my face. And your natural glam makeup is done. This is a very soft glam look that you can also do it during daytime while going out on a brunch date or going out with your girlfriends. It's a very versatile makeup. So I hope you guys really like this look, and if you did, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up. Also hit the subscribe button and the bell button so that you get notified every time I share a video. Also don't forget to follow me on my Facebook, Instagram and TikTok handle so that we can be friends. With that, this is Debbie signing off. I will see you again in my next video. Till then, bye bye.